In today's video, I'm going to be out taking some bluebell photos and I'm going to share with you my top tips for getting great bluebell images. Let's jump in. Hello and welcome to another video. So today I am taking full advantage, like most other landscape photographers in the UK at the moment, of the fact that the UK has probably about 50% of the world population of bluebells. And I've come to Emsworthy Mire to get an image of the barn, hopefully surrounded by bluebells. I know there's bluebells around it, but I'm not sure how they look. So what I'm hoping for, if you follow my channel, you'll know that I'm a bit of a sucker for a leading line going up to the subject. I think it looks really nice. So I'm hoping for that. I'm hoping that I can get something that goes right up to the barn. But in the meantime, let's roll some B-roll. Okay, so we have arrived at the barn, and this video is going to be a little bit different to most of the bluebell videos you'll see, because most of them will be in forests. But I'm lucky enough to have a absolutely beautiful subject right there. So just arriving now, I can see some really good compositions, I think. And I'm going to start right here with this shot. I'm just going to get down low to these bluebells just here, and I'm going to bring that in focus with the barn and no leading line, obviously, but just with the bluebells to try and make the bluebells look a little bit more abundant than what they actually are in this area. So I'm going to set up for that now. Okay, so this is probably about as close as I'm going to be able to get to the bluebells, because they are protected and you really shouldn't be trampling them for a photo or any other reason. So I will try and get this bunch just down here in the frame with the barn in the background, and hopefully can make it look like there's a few around. Okay, so my first composition, probably going to go with a square crop around the trees in the barn, and then the bluebells leading into the barn. Not sure if it's going to work, but I'll pop the image up on the screen. That's a very busy place. Got a lot of walkers. Now, this looks very nice, but doesn't really lead up to anything, but there is a little path just here that could make a nice composition. Obviously the leading line is what I'm after. I'd rather it was at the front of the barn. Excuse me, I'd rather it was at the front of the barn. I haven't been round to the front yet, so I don't know if there is going to be anything up there, but I'll grab this image. This is quite nice. Now, you have to be a little bit careful where you stand. They are protected, and it does take about 5 or 6 years, or maybe even longer, to establish a bluebell field, so they do take quite a long time to grow. So if you're going in and trampling it and killing them off. A, it's against the law, but B, obviously it does take a long time to re-establish those fields, and we want to try and keep them for everybody, so just have to be careful, stick to the paths, which is what I'm going to do now. All right, so leading line going up, barn, tree, tree, and then possibly a bit of this wall, but it's hard to tell because this is 4K cropped, so I can't show you on this live view, but there will be a little bit more bluebells and closer to the camera as well, so that's my next composition. Settings wise, I am going, so for my settings, what I'm going to do is F13 to get a nice depth of field, and then ISO 100. But actually, I'm on ISO auto ISO at the moment because I'll tell you why. I'm trying a little experiment out, which will be another video. So I've got auto ISO, and I'm on 1/100th of a second at the moment shutter speed. I am coming in from the center of the screen with the path at the moment. I do want to come from the very left and draw your eye in, but obviously, like I said, I can't, it's a bit hard where you set your camera up, so I might just try position it carefully around these bluebells in a second, but I'll have a look, see what this looks like first. So I'm going to pop this image up on the screen. Let me know in the comments what you think, and we'll have a look at the next one in a second. So getting down low is not only going to make your subject look bigger in the frame, it's also going to add depth to your image, because when you're up high on a tripod and looking down, it sort of flattens out the image and you don't really see the undulations, the dips and the mounds in the grass or in the ground or wherever you're taking your photos to. So getting down low with your subject can show those things like the rocks, and it can add a more interesting depth to the photo and make the photo a lot more interesting and a lot stronger. So another thing that's going to help with your bluebell images are to try and simplify as much as you can. So it's nice to have a big carpet of bluebells and then a subject, but if you've got too much going on either side or above or around your main subject, it could complicate the image too much and just make it not work. So trying to keep it as simple as you can will make the image a lot stronger. So one of the things you can do to improve your bluebell photos is get closer to your subject, because it's great seeing an entire field of bluebells, but sometimes when you get closer to something down low and on the level of the bluebells, it's going to make that photo 100 times more interesting than just seeing a really wide, undetailed shot. So the reason I've come down so low for this image is because I want to make the bluebells the star of the show. I don't want them to be the afterthought of the image. I want them to be leading you through to the barn, but I want the journey to be going across the bluebell field and up the path. And I've taken up pretty much 2/3 of the image with the bluebells, and then the barn is sort of quite small in the background, and I've intentionally cut off the sky as well because I don't want any distracting elements. So I don't want the big blue sky in the top of the image, because I think it would just take away from the bluebells. So that's where I'm going with this image. So I'll pop that up on the screen, and I'll show you a couple of others that I've taken just around this, just this little area here, from different angles and different perspectives, and have a look at what you think of them. I think personally, it just goes to show you don't really have to travel far to make your images look completely different, and it's all about just playing around with the different perspectives and seeing what you can come up with. So having a really good composition in your bluebell photos is a really important thing. And it goes with any photography, having a good composition, but it's ever so more important with bluebell photos to have a good subject, because you've got a big carpet of bluebells and it can take up, not depending on the type of image you're going for, but it can take up quite a lot of your frame. So if your eye doesn't really go anywhere, then the image won't really work. So what you need is to frame something in within that image. So have leading lines going up to, like in this case, having a barn. But if you look behind me here, this wouldn't really work as an image because you've got the leading line that goes up through the bluebells either side, but it doesn't really go anywhere, or it doesn't sort of end your eye anywhere. It's just a big open space. Whereas if you come this way, you're drawn up to the barn and that's your main focus point. So you can come through the image and you can have a lot of bluebell in the image, which makes them the star of the show, and also end somewhere. So your eye naturally comes to somewhere that is a focal point. So having that in your image will make your bluebell photos a lot better. So the next tip is one that most photographers will tell you, and that is practice. Practice is a really important aspect of photography, and probably most other aspects of any hobby or any other skill that you want to acquire. The more you do something, the better you get at it. But ever so more with bluebell photography, because they're only around for a month or so. So you're only getting, if you went out shooting every day, you're only getting a month's practice a year to get those bluebell photos you want. So it's ever so more important to get out and practice as much as you can whilst they're around. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the images as much as I've enjoyed taking them. It really is a special moment being able to take these photos, and it is such a fleeting moment that it's going to be gone in a couple of weeks maybe. So it's really been a pleasure. So while I enjoy these bluebells, I'll pop some more images up on the screen for you to have a look at. If you like the images, please do consider giving us a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed, please do consider hitting that subscribe button. It really does help with the algorithm. If you're hitting the like button and you like a video, it pushes it out to more people and it helps the channel grow. And I just appreciate it, as you know, what more do you need? So yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.